How to draw solids on a flat surface? See, 3D, what you see is 3D. Everywhere things are in 3D. But how to show or how to present them such that the 3D illusion is there. So we ought to have a visual illusion. This is how we make it. This is an oblique sketch. How we drew it? This is an oblique sketch because if I see it from the front, I'll see only this one. But if I see from here, my observer is here, he is able to see these two faces. Now we are able to make a 3D perception out of a 2D figure, but this is a 3D figure. We want to draw it in 3D. For example, how to draw it? Just take that we have a graph paper. We just have to draw this. Draw another one. And just join them. See, we just made this, joined it, and we just redraw this line in dotted. So this is the actual figure. This is the sketch. Actually, we have used only a screen, which is our 2D. But now you can perceive, this is an illusion that now this is in 3D. So this is an oblique sketch. Okay. The size of the front face and its opposite are same. The edges which are equal in cube, they appear so in the sketch, though the actual measure of edges are not taken. Okay, this is an oblique view. Now there is another method by isometric sheet. You can draw using isometric sheet. Isometrics are nothing but the points which are equally distributed, only points are there. So if the dimension is 4 by 3 into 3, that is 4 length, 3 breadth and 3 height, how you are going to make it? So these are isometric sketches. In isometric sketches, these are dotted lines. If you want to draw sketches in which the measurements also agree with those of the solid, then you have to use the isometric sheets. If you use the oblique sketch, then the side may or may not match. So here, if we have to draw 4 by 3 by 3. So 4 is the length, 3 is the breadth. So let us draw the length and breadth. This is length. This is our, say this is the height. So let us draw length and height first. This is length. So we took 4 dots. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 3 is the height. 1, 2, 3. Now 3 is the width. This one. So we extend these with 3 points. And now we join them. See? The final figure would be something like this. We have joined like this. So we connected the matching corners with appropriate line segments, and this is the isometric sketch of the cuboid. And we see the measurements are exact. If you take the oblique sketch, it may not be exact. So this is one more example how we can represent this with isometric sketch. If I can draw exactly like this, how I am going to draw this? First I will make this line 3. Okay, let me take any of these, say this one 3. Then 6. Let me take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then what we have to do here is, let me join this. Okay. Let me extend it to the width. Height and length we have used. Now 3 I am extending. 3, 3, 3, and now 3. Now let me join this. Okay. This is how it should look like.